Good morning, everyone. My name is Vincent, and I'm going to be talking to you about my PhD in the experimental validation of bent twist coupling stiffness predictions. I'm going to start with a brief introduction to kind of give you the motivation of my research, and then I'll talk about both numerical and the experimental work I've done, and then wrap up with some conclusions and future work. So bent twist coupling is quite an old technology. It was first sort of researched back, I think, even in the 70s or earlier by NASA. And when you look in the literature, it's easy to find lots of research showing all the advantages of bent twist coupling. Now there's two methods. One is using sort of geometrical sweep and these kind of features, and the other is using material properties. So when you utilize the anisotropic properties of composite materials, what you can do is you can create a section that has the fibers kind of dominantly at an off angle to the beam, and then what will happen is that beam, when it's bent, will start to twist. And this twist can be used in sort of aerialistic tailoring to reduce the loading on the blade and have sort of cost benefits on the long run. However, when you look in the literature, it's also quite common to find disagreement. So two different analysis techniques might disagree on the exact performance of a given design. And this is problematic because that means that for industrial partners, it's difficult to implement this technology if you don't have the certainty about what the performance is going to be. So the motivation behind my research really is to kind of give that certainty, or give more certainty, let's say, that the solvers can be trusted, and that will then allow this technology to be commercialized on a wider scale. So initially I started with my numerical work to design five demonstrators. Now the first two, which I've already fully built and tested and which I'll show some results from later, are sort of a simple box and elliptical section. These act as baselines. Most of the modelers agree very, very well on what the performance of this kind of simple section should be. So with this, I can baseline my experimental test setup, get certainty in all the properties I'm putting in, and then the remaining three sections each incorporate one key feature of a full complex blade that includes the web, core material, which is soft and changes the shear flow behavior and therefore the twist behavior significantly, and then finally kind of a wider teardrop type section. Interestingly, when I'm doing my analysis using two cross-sectional solvers known as BKS and VABS, which are sort of industrial standards, as well as 3D FEM, so this shell and solid element models in Abacus, I find very, very good agreement. So BKS and VABS agree 100% on all the performance parametrics of the blade sections, and even the 3D FEM generally agrees quite well, with the primary bending and torsional stiffness coefficients being within 1%, and the coupling term being normally within 2.5%. However, I've discovered quite quickly that it has very strong dependence on input handling. And this is something that has been suggested in the literature as well. Some authors have shown that if you don't handle certain features well, you could end up getting errors. And to kind of showcase this, for an example of my web section, from a manufacturing point of view, we know there's going to be an internal corner there. But because modelers are lazy, we tend to just create a straight web because that corner is a bit of a nightmare to mesh. However, what I found is that while for the primary stiffness coefficients that's fine, the effect is negligible, in a bent twist coupled compliant blade design, the bent twist coupling terms, the amount of twist you're going to get under bending is actually affected quite a lot. Now, you can play around with exactly what material properties you put in these regions to offset that slightly, but still these features appear to be far more critical for these types of blade designs than they may be for more traditional designs without bent twist coupling and which are less compliant. To back all this modeling up, of course, I'm doing some experimental work, because that's the whole point, experimental validation. And so I build my beams using glass epoxy at the NCC, making use of our collaboration links there. And to get good stability and geometric tolerance, I use steel tools with a wax layer. This allows me to lay up, get very good shape control, and in a post-process, I melt the wax out, and then I've got a beautifully prismatic beam. I then test these here using under the cantilevered condition, using calibrated inclinometers. It gives me a very precise localized measure of twist. And I use repeated load cycles to ensure, of course, that my results are repeatable. So here we see some results for one of the first two beams. We have the experimental data in crosses, and then there's two sets of data, both from BKS and from the finite element. And we can see the initial predictions I made seemed to be stiffer than the blade. So this is the twist angle along the length. So we seem to be predicting more twist. However, it seems that the material properties that I was using may have been wrong because the material was also thicker than it was supposed to be. I started to do some material characterization and it looks like indeed the material knockdown factor I used to correct for this increase in thickness might be appropriate, but I still need to do more detailed material characterization to ensure that these predictions are actually correct. So in conclusion,
I started off with some numerical studies where I found good correlation but high model sensitivity to inputs. This leads to my future work where I want to further investigate these. So I want to try more different modeling simplifications as well as manufacturing tolerances, which can be quite large in wind turbine blades. And then finally, also, I have my 5 demonstrators, most of which are now built and being tested. And so, of course, I want to confirm material properties to ensure that what I'm putting in my models is correct, and then use that baseline then to further validate the remaining cross-sections. I would like to acknowledge and thank Vestas for their continued support of this project. And I will now gladly take any questions you may have.